Hi, welcome to the Black TV Show Podcast. I'm your host, Miriam Temeskin.
Hello, and welcome back to the podcast. This is episode 18. I am breaking down the episode, The Cosby Show, Season 1, Episode 18, Vanessa's New Class. So this episode aired on February 14th, 1985. So it was aired on Valentine's Day, but it's not a Valentine's Day episode. We start off with seeing Vanessa in her room working on her science project, which is the solar system. And Denise comes in and talks to her, be like, is this your science project? And she's like, yeah. And she's like, this is all nine planets. It is no longer nine planets in the solar system right now. It's been said that there are only eight planets. Pluto, which is the planet that is furthest away from the sun, they have now called that a dwarf planet, which means it's not part of the solar system. But it's so weird to see that, like, in this episode, she says, I have all nine planets. I remember when I was in school, we studied that there was nine planets also. So it's so weird to see it like now in 2021 that it's a totally different thing. So Denise comes in and says, oh, it looks pretty good. By the tone of her voice, it just doesn't seem like she likes it. And Vanessa was like, what's wrong with it? You know, and Denise asked, like, when was it due? Denise was like, how long have you known about this project? And she was like, a month and a half. And how many days have you spent on this? And she's like, four nights. And Denise was like, well, if this was a real solar system, we would have a four planet collision. Like, she should have had each planet revolve separately, because the way it looks is that all of the planets revolve at the same time, which is not true. That's not a real solar system. And so I understand with Denise, but also, you know, I think Vanessa at this age, she's like 11, so she's in grade 6. Like, to me, that looks like a nice project. It's really, that's the effort I would put in. Clearly, I was not a good student back in the day, but that would probably be the effort I would put in. I wouldn't put it all separately. So Vanessa mentions, like, she gets all A's all the time. And Denise was like, this is an advanced science course. Like, you need to put more effort into the project. So then we cut to the kitchen. And Theo's reading a book, so clearly he's studying and he's eating. And Claire asks if he's done with the bowl. And he's like, no. And she's like, okay, well, then you're going to wash the bowl because I'm about to start the dishwasher. And all of a sudden, he quickly just eats all of it and, like, gives her the bowl. That is so mean. Because I'm like, I don't want to wash that dishes. It's just easy to put in the dishwasher. Claire decides to put the dishwasher on, and it's not working. It is broken. And Claire is freaking out because she's like, if Cliff knows, then that means he's going to try to fix it. And he's going to make it worse than it is. And one of the things is, throughout this series, that is a theme. Where whenever something is broken in the house, Cliff wants to fix it, even though he does not have the skills to fix all the, this one's a dishwasher. I believe there is an episode where he tries to fix the bathroom shower. There's an episode, there's a whole season at the season 8 is all like him trying to fix a doorbell, and it's just not working. And so, and like the whole family just hates whenever he tries it, because he makes everything worse. It's just, you're making the problem worse. And I agree with Theo when he mentions that, you know, it's just easier just to go ask a repairman to fix it than to you to make it worse. And then we're going to have to call a repairman again, and then it might cost more money. And so Claire was like, told Theo, we need to get all these dishes washed right now before Cliff comes in. So they take all the dishes out and put it in the dishwasher, or into the sink. And all of a sudden Cliff walks in, and all of a sudden they put back the dishes into the dishwasher. And they were like, well, we don't need to wash them now. We'll wash it later. Cliff said, is the dishwasher broken? He knew right away right there. And so Claire was like, oh, it's no need you fixing it. We can call a repairman and they can fix it. And Cliff was like, no, we're going to be getting charged $35 to be told that there's a part to fix that dishwasher in Minnesota. And Theo, as I said, he mentions, like, even if you try to fix the dishwasher, we're still going to call a repairman. And Cliff was like, we? Since when did Theo start paying bills? He is not a we, you know? And Claire reminds him about the time that he tried to fix the fridge. This, of course, never happened in the series, but this must be a time when we're in the past. And Cliff says that Theo will have to help him fix the dishwasher after school. And Theo's just not happy. He's just like, I don't want to deal with this. So then Vanessa comes down into the kitchen and she has her solar system project. And Rudy's trying to play with Mars because the ball that is, representing Mars is Rudy's ball. And Vanessa was like, not until after the science fair is over. And Cliff tells Rudy, you can play with it after the science fair is over. And the fact that she has made a contribution to science. And Rudy's like, okay, that's good. She really doesn't know what that means. But yeah. And so Cliff and Claire are happy about the solar system and the fact that she wrote a whole 9-page report about the solar system. And Claire asks Vanessa, Claire to ask Vanessa a question about the solar system. So Claire asks, what is the atmosphere like on the planet Saturn? And so she said it includes methane and molecular hydrogen. That's basically hydrogen. Average temperature is 350 below zero. This has to be Fahrenheit, by the way. The wind velocity is 100 miles per hour. So I went to look this up if this is the actual truth. I did not look up the wind velocity. That's to me just irrelevant at this point. It is relevant, but just for this episode, I was like, I'm not going to look that up. So the atmosphere is mostly hydrogen, helium, methane, and ammonia. What it said, it was that mostly hydrogen and helium, and then methane, and then a little drops of ammonia. And the temperature is minus 285 degrees Fahrenheit. So clearly, Saturn has warmed up since 1985. Or whatever Vanessa said was wrong. I have no idea what's true, what's not. So, the doorbell rings and Vanessa tells Cliff to go open the door. It's Janet Miser. The first time we're meeting her. So I didn't know if we're going to meet her in this season or if we're going to meet her in the second season. But we are meeting her now. She has been mentioned, I feel like, since episode 3. But we just never seen her. So Cliff goes and opens the door and he makes some jokes with her. You know, have we seen each other? Have we, you know, all this kind of questions. And Janet tells Cliff that, you know, Vanessa and her decided to not tell each other about their science projects until they got to the fair. So they told each other, we're going to keep this a secret to each other. And so then Vanessa comes with her solar system, but it's in a box, so that way it's easier to carry it to the school. And Janet was mentioning that she's been working on this project since the last minute. Vanessa was like, I finished this project 2 days ago. And Claire says, and then Cliff mentions that Vanessa did a whole, I don't know what it was, like a whole spacecraft or something. And and Vanessa was like, that's not true. That's not my project. And so they leave to go to school. And Claire mentions to Cliff, like, why are you putting so much competition on these kids? They already have a lot of competition as it is. Because he mentioned that her project was like a spacecraft thing. I can't remember what the exact words he said, but like he was trying to like hype Vanessa up. And so she mentions that like when he plays Monopoly, it is like usually when people play Monopoly, it's to just play a game, but he takes it way too serious. He like tries to murder you basically through the game, you know. Claire just doesn't want to get Vanessa carried away just like her dad. So we are at the school. And Vanessa and Janet bring in their projects. They're both still in a box. And we meet a person, we meet a kid named Nancy. She has an ant farm. And all of a sudden, her ants are all over the place. They're just sneaking away. That is so bad. Because then now the school is like, there's going to be too many ants crawling around their school. Like, I wouldn't want to be in a school like that. The teacher mentions to her, you know, if we can't find enough ants, then you can redo the project. She could use the weekend to get more ants, and he could judge her project separately. And Vanessa overhears that because, like, she's seeing all these projects being better than hers. So she's just like, I kind of want to redo my project so it looks better. Then we meet Todd Lucas. He has a volcano. And Janet asks Vanessa, like, does that volcano work? And Vanessa was like, I hope not. Sigh. So much shade right there. We meet another person named Melissa. She created solar energy. And it, like, I don't know how to describe it. But it, like, it had a windmill. But the material of it, it looked like kind of like pasta material, which is weird. But it was probably something else. But it was to create solar energy. And then Leon, who was under the sheets, so clearly his project was underneath it. We just know there's a person named Leon, but we don't see his face at this moment. And then, so Janet and Vanessa, they put their projects onto their table, and they were deciding who should show their project first. So Janet was like, okay, I'll go first. So she did robotics. So she made one robotic where I think it's like a remote that commands it to move, and then one that's commanded by sound. So by clapping, it moves. And I'm like, what? 11-year-old can make a robotics? Like, you must, like, these kids are genius. Like, I don't even know how would I make something like robotic like that? So Vanessa's just like so jealous of Janet, and Vanessa's kind of like mad. And Vanessa mentions that, you know, that she made the solar system. Leon comes out of the sheets and says that he made the solar system in the third grade and had flaming asteroids. Leon mentioned that he was working, like, his project was a tornado. And Melissa says, it's not hard to make a tornado. What? To make a little it's like a table size tornado, that seems hard. I don't know, there might be methods. And think about it, like, this is before the times of Google. Like, how do they have this much knowledge to create this stuff? I feel like now with Google and YouTube, basically YouTube tutorials, you can learn how to make this stuff, but they didn't have that. They just had books. So it's, these kids are genius. That's all I gotta say. And so Vanessa goes to the teacher and says, can I bring my project back on Monday? I need to add more to it. And the teacher said no. And so we end the act one right there. And we go into act two. And we're in the kitchen. And all the parts of the dishwasher is taken out. It is like disassembled. It's a mess. And Cliff is just mad that he hasn't been able to fix it. Theo says, I'm home. And Cliff rushes and puts everything back in the dishwasher, even a teapot. Why would he put a teapot? Leave the teapot on the oven. I had to rewatch this clip. I was like, the teapot is on the oven. That's where a teapot is supposed to be. Why is it in a dishwasher? It doesn't make sense. You don't even wash I don't wash a teapot in the dishwasher. That's not where it's meant to be. You're supposed to hand wash that. So Theo comes in, and Cliff is mad that Theo is 15 minutes late because he finished school at 3 but didn't come home until 3:15. Like, really? Cliff, you're mad at yourself. You're not mad. You're mad at the wrong person. And Cliff says he needs to fix the dishwasher. And so Vanessa and Janet come in from school. Vanessa asks what happened to the dishwasher. And Theo says, life was too easy for him, because Cliff mentioned to Theo that life was too easy for him because he didn't know how to fix a dishwasher. And so Cliff asks, like, did you win the science fair? And Vanessa was like, no, Leon Haywood won a science fair. It was that tornado. He really made it so lifelike. And like Janet mentions, like, she mentions how bad a tornado really makes it devastating for a community just by looking at Leon's project. The fact that they learned a lesson from that project is, it's great. Like, he did a good job and he deserves first place. And Janet came in third. Vanessa came in 14th. So Vanessa's just not really, like, that happy. So they decided to go up to the Vanessa's room. And Cliff goes back and sees Theo and Cliff tells Theo that we need to get the washing machine working before Claire comes home. Because you know Claire. She will roast him on how he should never fix anything ever again. So we're in Vanessa's room, and like Janet is just talking to Vanessa and saying, you know, oh, it looks like Leon was liked you and all that stuff. And Vanessa's like, okay, whatever, I don't really care. And she was just not in the mood because she came in 14th. And Vanessa says that Janet was smart enough to have a parent help her on her project. And Janet was like, I didn't get help, I did this on my own. And Vanessa's like, no, you have a father that is an engineer. That is suspect right there. When you have a parent that's in that particular field, I don't know. But Janet said she did it all by herself. That's why she waited until the last minute to get it done. Unlike Vanessa, who only spent 4 days. And so Janet was like, okay, well, I'm just going to go home. And so Cliff is on the phone in the living room, and he's talking to a salesman about getting the same model as the dishwasher that they have. Because then that way he doesn't get in trouble from Claire, and Claire can say, oh, wow, Cliff was able to fix the dishwasher. You know, that's what he's trying to accomplish right there. And he said that he tells the salesman that he has to bring it in before 5:30, because that's when Claire comes home from work. Janet comes down the stairs and tells Cliff, I want to go home and ask for a ride. And he's confused. He was like, okay, well, I just got to get my keys and jacket, and then we'll go. So he runs up to Vanessa's room. He asks Vanessa, is everything okay? And she's like, yeah. And he's like, well, Janet asked me to give her a ride home. It seems weird. That's a short visit. And so she's like, yeah. And like, so Cliff was like, what's really going on? Like, Vanessa was like, ever since she's won third place, she has been impossible. Cliff was like, she's only won for a couple minutes. Like, she hasn't won for so long. And then Vanessa adds on and says, I think her dad helped her on her project. And Cliff was like, did you ask her that? And she's like, yeah. And she said no. And then Vanessa it seems like Vanessa's just all over the place. She's just mad at everyone. So then Vanessa talks about like how hard of a time she had to make this project with Rudy bothering her and Claire not letting her work in the kitchen. And then also she thinks that her teacher doesn't like her, and the fact that Cliff only gave her $10 for the project. Cliff says, so you're just blaming a whole bunch of people for ruining your project for you, basically. And so Cliff was like, what is the real problem? And she was like, I thought I did a good job, but when I saw all the other projects, I thought I could have done better. And I understand, I feel like sometimes I do blame other people for what I should be blaming myself for. So I understand that how she was so all over the place with this. I feel like that's how I was a kid when I didn't get things done, or I was not seen or anything. I would just blame the world. So I understand how Vanessa's really feeling about where, like, her mindset is at. And Vanessa said, you know, she didn't work hard enough and she could have done 70% more. Vanessa should have listened to Denise when Denise was like, it's not that great. It should have been all separate. revolving, all the planets should have been revolving separately. And Vanessa asked Cliff, you know, can she borrow $20? She said borrow. She ain't giving that money back. That is the wrong term. She should have said, can I have $20? I don't know why. I tend to do that too. I do ask people, like, can I borrow? And like, nowadays, I'll actually pay people back. But back when I was like maybe a student where I wasn't making enough money, like, no. Like, I would have never returned the money. And so she wanted the $20 because she wanted to finish her project. And Cliff was like, well, the fair is over. Like, the competition is over. And she was like, no, I want to redo it for myself. And I was like, wow. And so Cliff holds her tight. And she's like, I can't breathe. And Cliff was like, well, love hurts. And so Cliff tells Vanessa that he will take her and Janet out for pizza. When I first heard that, I was like, oh, is it because the dishwasher is broken? I wonder, you know? And so, and Vanessa was happy, and she asked for, I don't know if she asked for no crust or something like that, and Cliff was like, you're pushing it. So then, it's maybe, I feel like, an hour later, and Theo comes, we're in the living room, and Cliff is waiting at the door. It seems like he's waiting for Claire to come home. And Theo comes and tells Cliff that he doesn't want to go out for pizza because Vanessa and Janet always makes fun of him. And like, Cliff was like, yeah, because you're funny. Because whenever the pizza comes, it comes super hot, and everyone waits to have a pizza, but you decide to just grab it while the cheese is still like dripping and you burn your mouth, basically. And it's so funny when you do it. And so he walks away. And Vanessa and Janet come, and they're just laughing a lot. So I guess they're back to their normal selves. And then they go, and Cliff asks to get them to go get Rudy. And Claire comes home from work, and Cliff was like, don't take off your jacket. We're going out for pizza. She's like, okay. And she starts walking towards the kitchen. And Cliff was like, where are you going? She was like, I just want juice. And he's like, well, there's juice at the pizza place, you know? So she goes, grabs a glass, grabs that juice, starts drinking the juice. And Claire asks, you know, how's Vanessa doing? And Cliff was like, she did not go over her head in terms of, you know, that competition mindset, basically, that Cliff has. So Claire goes to the dishwasher so she could put her glass into the dishwasher. And looks at the huge mess. It's like the racks that usually you put the dishes on are not like horizontal. It's like diagonal, and you can't use it. It's just not you cannot use that dishwasher, basically. And Claire calls out, we need to help this other child. And Cliff was like, oh, Theo? No, it's you, Cliff. You're the other child that needs help. And Claire says that Vanessa needs to have a talk with Cliff of him going over his head on trying to fix things. And Claire says to Cliff, do you promise to never fix anything in this house? And he's like, yeah, I promise. Lies. That is lies. We're going to see in other episodes where he does not fix, we'll see in other episodes that he's going to try to fix things in the house. Just as I said, the shower, the doorbell. There's more. I just can't think of the rest of them. But so that thing is a lie. But we end the episode right there. So we met Janet Miser. So the person that's playing her is Pam. Oh my God! I'm sorry. As I said, I say people's names wrong. Pam Potolo. And she actually stopped acting after the Cosby Show. I'm not sure why, but she did go to university. She went to Rutgers University. I actually met someone a year ago when I was in Barcelona that did go to Rutgers University. He was like repping them so much. So I was like, it must be a good like school. And then she went to do her master's at Pepperdine University, which I've heard that that is an expensive university. Not sure if that's true, but I've heard things like that. And so I feel like the lesson for this episode is true friendship is seeing the best in your friend, even though they might be more successful than you. That's what I feel like with Janet and Vanessa. You know, Vanessa, you know, she cares for her friend, but she'd rather be number one and then her friend be number two. And sometimes that's not the case. You might be number two and your friend is number one. So I feel like that's what I learned from this episode, that if you really care about your friend, you're not going to put that friend down. And so the question that I have for you guys is, has there been a time where you become jealous of your friend? Let me know using the hashtag ScienceFair at Black TV Shows Pod. Black Show of the Week. Sorry for my bad singing. So today's Black Show of the Week is girlfriends. I'm sorry, that's not the right tempo. But yes, today I'm going to be talking about girlfriends. If you don't know about this show, I feel sorry for you. It came out in 2000 and it went all the way to 2008 with 8 seasons. The 8th season, unfortunately, ending not like what we were hoping due to a writer's strike. So the show was created by Mara Brock Akil, who was actually a writer, a screenwriter for Moesha, which I never seen Moesha until it went onto Netflix. And I would see certain episodes with Mara's name on it. So it was like, cool. And so she had, so back in the day, there was a network called UPN. And they came to Mara and asked her, you know, if she would have a companion piece to the show The Parkers. If you guys don't know, The Parkers is a spin-off show to Moesha. So now they want another show to be a companion show to The Parkers. And she pitched the idea of girlfriends. But the problem was she didn't have a studio. Typically, in the normal world of getting shows on the air is typically you would partner up with a studio and then pitch it to networks. But in her situation, she had a network, but no studio. So Kelsey Grammer, if you guys don't know who he is, which probably you'd know who he is. I've never seen anything that he's worked on, but he's from the show Frasier and Cheers. He had a production deal, I believe with Paramount. But the problem is he didn't have any shows running, didn't book anything. And so they went to him and he was like, yeah, let's create a show. Which is weird, like to have a white man be an executive producer of a show about 4 black ladies is a very odd combination. But it worked. And there was an interview that Mara did and she's like, the fact that he just said yes was all I needed for him. I didn't care if he didn't do anything else. The fact that he gave me an opportunity to showcase this to the world is all that matters to her. So that's the great part, you know, to have Kelsey Grammer say yes to her pitch. The show showcases the professional lives and the personal lives with dating and sex and mainly their friendships with each other. And the show stars Tracy Ellis Ross, who plays Joan Clayton. She is the den mother of the friends, of the girlfriends. And if you don't know who she is, she's currently starring in Blackish. And she has another show called Mixish. And also she has a legendary mother named Diana Ross. So she's just doing her thing. And her character was really the one taking care of all her friends. Really being there for them, even if it's compromises with her life, she's always there for her friends. And then there's Golden Brooks, who played Maya Wilkes, who was a working class and she was from the hood. I can't remember if she is from Compton, if I'm mistaken. I have to rewatch the show for the third time to know where exactly. But she's from the hood. She is ghetto. I love her. I feel like I don't relate to her, but I love her character. To see her progression throughout the seasons, like from her being so ghetto, that's all I can really think of, to becoming a professional woman by the end of the series, it's amazing. Then there's Persia White, who plays Lynn. She is the sexually adventurous girlfriend of the group. She tends to be a little weird here and there. And she is half white, half black, but was raised by white parents who adopted her. And throughout the series, you'll see like her trying to find her biological parents and really honing on her blackness, because the majority of her life was really she was only really honing her whiteness. And then there's Jill Marie Jones, who plays Antoinette Childs. Her nickname is Tony. I'm not gonna lie, I really don't like her character. Every time I see her, it bothers me. Nothing against Jill, it's just the actual character I really don't like. I don't know if I would want to be friends with that person. She is very shallow, but she's one of the popular one in the girlfriends and self-proclaimed cute one of the group. But she's just uptight. She wants what she wants. You know, she's the first class. I feel like the person I could think of relating her to is Hillary. But the only thing is, Tony is she's a boss. She is a real estate agent. She gets that money, but she also wants to have a man that has that money. She ain't settling for less. But as I said, it bothered me, her character on the show. But I love Jill. And then there's Reggie Hayes, who plays William Dent. He's the girl's closest male friend. I like his character. He's not like I don't want to say this. I hate when people say this, but like he isn't the good looking kind of guy. He's just that friend that you go to talk to and stuff. I don't like to say that because everyone in the world is beautiful in their own certain ways. But in terms of what we see in media, he's not the standard, you know, model body type of person. He is just that regular friend that you would always have that works, you know, he's a lawyer, and eventually he becomes something else within the job that he's in. And I really like his character. I feel like I have a friend just like that who I could always go to talk to. And then we have Khalil Kane, who plays Darnell Wilkes, who is Maya's husband, and then at some point might be ex-husband and then husband. I don't know. It's very complicated. But what's crazy about Darnell Wilkes is in season one, Flex Alexander plays him, and then after season one, Khalil plays him. And the reason why it switches people is because Flex end up getting the show one-on-one with Kayla Pratt, so he left Girlfriends and then they brought in Khalil. I'm not gonna lie, I kind of wish Flex was never in the first season. I feel like Khalil would have been a better choice for the first season. It just, he does the character way so much better, I feel like. And he's a working class man. He's nonstop working. And Maya and Darnell were teen parents. And throughout the show, you'll see them raising their son. And then Keisha Sharp, she doesn't become part of the main the main cast until, I believe, season 7, but she dates William. So that is the main cast. As I said, the show ran for 8 seasons, but season 8 didn't go for a full season. The Writers Guild of America went on strike, canceled the show. And in order to finish the series, or finish with at least a closing series finale, it would have been too expensive, and they even offered the actors to pay them only half of their usual salary to take part, but the actors collectively turned them down. I don't blame them, because it's not worth that. Especially black cast in America, like, being a black cast, you're already getting paid less than probably your white counterparts, so I don't blame them for
turning that down. But we all do need closure. And as Charlemagne the God would say, he's from the radio show The Breakfast Club. We need closure. We need a movie. Can someone give Mara Brock Akil $20 million to make this movie? I think that's what she's saying. She wants that, or maybe even more. She wants a lot of money in order to make it the way she wants to make it. Can someone do that, please? We need a movie. A lot of people do say that Girlfriends is the black version of Sex in the City. I have never seen Sex in the City, so I wouldn't know. But they've had already two movies. They were able to finish their series, and I heard that they're having another show coming out probably in 2021 or 2022, but it's not called Sex and the City. It's called something else because one of the characters is not in. I don't know the details because I've never seen the show. But that is not fair. We need closure. We need to know where these characters are. Are Joan and Tony still friends? We don't know. So, and you gotta figure out why I just said that by watching the series. So there was many guest stars on the show. There was Yvette Nicole Brown, Angie Stone, Beverly Johnson, Big Boy, Shantae Moore, Chanel Brown, Cosette Michelle, Common, Kobe Bell, Don Lewis, Dondre Whitfield, Drew Sidora, Dwayne Martin, Erica Badu, Evan Ross, Jose, I can never say his last name, but he's on the game, Idris Elba, James Avery, Jennifer Lewis, Jill Scott, Joe Marie Payton, Kadeem Hardison, Cat Williams, Kelly Rowland. Oh my god, Kelly Rowland did such a good job. She was actually not even, she was like in four episodes and she did such a good job acting. I'm like, girl, why don't you keep doing it? I feel like she's only been on a few other shows, but I feel like she should have gone, and I think she had a Lifetime movie that came out last year, but I just feel like she should do more acting. She did so good. Whew, that's just you gotta watch the show to see what I'm talking about. There's Kenya Moore, Kimberly Elise, who is the character that deals with HIV and AIDS, Layla Ali, Loretta Devine, Malik Yobo, Master P, Monique Omarosa, Reverend L. Sharpton, Richard Jones, Shar Jackson, Sinbad, Tasha Smith, Terry J. Vaughn, Tia Mori, Wayne Brady, Wendy Raquel Robertson, and Wendell Pierce. Sorry, it takes me a while to say all that list of names. That is a lot of special guests that were on the show. So the show really talked about, here are some of the topics. They talked about toxic friendship, feminism, race and identity. That's mostly dealing with Lynn. Abortion, HIV, AIDS, being sex positive, the N-word. So, and for people that don't know, there was actually another show that came out of Girlfriends. The show is called The Game. And that's why Tia Mori actually was on Girlfriends, because to create the side show. And Mara Brock Akil also created The Game. So one day we'll talk about The Game. It's a really good show. It was on the CW and it was on BET. And I believe now it's on Netflix in the US. Right now at this moment, it's not in Canada. So I'm not sure when that will be when it's on in Canada. But it's such a good show. I've seen it. But with Girlfriends, it's currently streaming on Netflix. So I recommend you to watch it. So the next episode will be episode 19 with season 1 being Claire's Case. I am going to end this podcast with the theme song of Girlfriends because I cannot sing it. So I will see you all on the next one. My girlfriend.